Let us take one example from physics where we are going to use this approximation method. And in gravitation, you know acceleration due to gravity. Earth and its mass is capital M, the radius is capital R. Do you know the formula for acceleration due to gravity on the surface of Earth? G is equal to G capital M by R square. And what is the acceleration due to gravity at a height h from the surface of Earth? So GH is equal to GM by, again the distance of that point from center, R plus H whole square. And from here you can write G capital M as G into capital R square. Capital G is universal gravitational constant. That is equal to G R square by R plus H whole square. And R value is equal to 6400 kilometers. And a small g value on the surface of Earth is approximately 9.8 meter per second square. So if you give me the value of height by substituting R value, H value, small g value on the surface of Earth, I can calculate the acceleration due to gravity at any height from the surface of Earth. But the thing is, suppose if I give h is equal to some 5 kilometers, what I have to do? Gh is equal to 9.8 meter per second square into 6400 kilometer by 6400 plus 5. 405 kilometer whole square, here also square. So 6400 square we have to do, and 6405 square we have to do, and again we have to divide. The problem becomes very lengthy. Of course it is possible, but it takes much time. But anyway, as far as this height is concerned, it is very less than 6400 kilometers. That's why I am going to approximation method. That is, this approximation method is correct only when h is very much less than capital R, or h by R is very much less than 1. Just now we have seen, if x is very much less than 1, x square, x cube terms will be neglected. In the same way, if h by r is very much less than 1, h by r whole square or h by r whole cube and so on, those higher order terms we can neglect it. And let us have this equation in terms of h by r. So gh is equal to g into r square by r square, r you take common, r square into 1 plus h by r whole square, cancel. So g into 1 plus h by r whole power minus 2, and 1 plus x whole power n. So when x is very much less than 1, I can write it as 1 plus nx. N is minus 2, x is h by r, that's all. So g into 1 minus 2 h by r, this is acceleration due to gravity at any height h from the surface of Earth. And we have to use this equation only when h is very much less than capital R, means approximately, generally we prefer to use this formula up to height h is 100 kilometers. More than 100 kilometers, so we don't go for this approximation method. We go for exact method, g r square, r plus this 100 kilometers, next to whole square, we are going to use this formula. And I have seen some students, are going to conclude from this formula. So when H is equal to R by 2, 2H is equal to R. So 1 minus R by R, it becomes 0 na. So acceleration due to gravity at a height H is equal to R by 2, it will be 0. It is very funny that the students are going to use at this height, because R by 2 means 3200 kilometers. Of course, the conclusion we can make, we can draw from this formula, but using that formula itself is wrong, because this formula is only correct when H is very much less than capital R. So at no height, GH will not be 0. That's it.